Welcome to RyCurricul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to test API application using TestTrigger. For testing API using TestTrigger, we need to have the TestTrigger account credentials, and from there, we want the API and URL. For creating the API and URLs, we are going to use Atlassian product, which is Jira, and we'll generate API tokens. For generating API tokens in Jira, we will use id.atlassian.com. From here, we will create API tokens. For creating API tokens, I'm simply defining here API label. So I'm just naming here test trigger and click on create. Once I will click on create, it will generate API tokens. I will simply copy and paste it here. We will use this API token into our API testing. We are done with the API tokens. Let's create an API testing suits. So I've already created the API testing suits here. We have to define the name, then type of testing. Then the username and password is not required because we are doing the authentications in between our JSON file. Post that, we have to select in the operating system, browser, and how many test cases we want to create it. So simply I've already created it. So without wasting time, let's jump into the API testing suits where we have some of the API test cases of the year. So for building the API test cases, we need to have the authentications or authorizations. For authorization point of view, if I will open Postman and show you some of the scripts, which is the RAN, into my previous call. So that time we will able to see body and the header sections or authorizations. So these all parameters will be there. But what if we want to generate exactly same parameter and send and face the request or get the request, we will be able to see it here. So in that case, we want that authorization, that is username and password. So in terms of password, we will use same API password and username is exactly same thing, but we cannot directly use this username and password into the test trigger. Rather than using directly, we have some alternatives, and these alternatives, we will find it here in the documentation sections where they have JSON part to be generated. So if you'll click on the API testings, here you can see JSON path and variable name has to be generated. And for generating this, they have provided few links to generate this. So let's do it in one of the website. This is a website where we can generate that authorization password, right? So here we have to define the end URL of this Atlassian application where we want to hit the request. So right now I will use till here issues, add into this box, and post that we are going to hit a call first get. So here I want the username. So username is always exactly same username which we are using. So let me copy and paste it to here. And the token is exactly same token. We will copy and paste it into the password section. Post that, it will generate my raw token, and I will copy and paste my complete raw token into authorization section. So let me paste it here. Now my complete prerequisites are completed. So let's go to add custom test cases. And from here, first I will call get method. So get request, and here syntax is very simple, where by writing these syntaxes, we will feel that it's very easy to use test trigger for API testing. So here we are going to use a plain English language text. So we are going to call API calls. So right now call API get method, and in between double quotes, we will define the complete path from where we want to call the data. So right now We are going to call from here. Exactly same link, we will use it. Now it's done. And post that space with headers in double quotes. We'll use exactly same headers which we have defined here. Then application JSON and accept. Now our headers are done. After that, we'll use and authorization. So authorization we have just generated. We'll simply copy and paste complete authorization format which we have generated. Now post that we want a get method and get double quotes dollar dot fields. So here we are going to call the ID. So if you can see here, my complete ID is wrapped into in between fields. And suppose that, let me change this, get and remove this, comment, click on send. If you can see here, this is wrapped in between fields, then ID and issue type and then ID. So here we will generate the call fields, then dot issue type and post that ID. So here dot issue type dot ID and save it as ID. So if you can see here, when we have executed the command and so it is showing the pass method, and when we'll click on show extra info, we'll be able to see complete detail about the defect. So you can see here, the issue details are listed here, is in the complete size text. Everything is available about the issue which we have extracted it from Jira. So this will show us how the account ID, then the Atlassian product detail, and which all details we are getting it from Postman API. Exactly same thing we can extract it from here. So this is the power of Test Trigger, where we can get details. Let's create one more script for post method. So right now we are going to create in post method. Let's copy exactly same code from here and we'll make the changes so that I will show you the differences how we can run this in post. So for doing post method, simply we have to write here post, same command we'll use it, but this time we are going to add some comments. So for adding the comments, the URL will definitely change. So here comment with header. So right now at the time of writing post method, we need exactly same thing, all this detail except body. So here we are going to use, instead of this method, we will add body and then space in double quotes and then the curly brackets. Post that, we'll use this double quotes, body, again double quotes, then for that, and post that inside the body, we are going to provide a value. So value here, I will mention in between double quotes, this comment is from Test Trigger. Okay, before that we'll have this and curly bracket close. So if you can see here inside my projects, I have the defect ID 48. In defect ID, we don't have the exactly same descriptions in the comment sections which we have just added. So let me show you here in defect 48, not in this one. In defect, you can see here these many defects which is available here. But if we want to add more defects like this, so more comments like this in this defect, then we are just defining this is a this comment is from Test Trigger. Now, once I will click on add and run, Okay, and post that we have one more quotes. Yeah, once I will click on add and run, this will go to the my Jira account, post the comment and show the status accordingly. So if you can see here, within a second we will be able to see the exactly same comments which we have mentioned into our test trigger. Post that comment will be available here. So let's wait for the execution. Post execution, we'll be able to see that comments has been successfully added. So let me refresh this page and you'll be able to see this comment has added successfully. So this comment is from test trigger. This is how we can get or extract the detail from Jira using test trigger, and whenever it is required, we can make a post. It means we are doing get and post both the methods by using test trigger. So that's the power of test trigger tool, which is AI based tool where we can test or API testing applications easily by just writing plain English language. That scripts will be built in plain English language. Hope you like the content. If you really think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. And if you have any queries or suggestion, add inside the comment section. Thank you for watching.